This is me, Alex Cronin, the general in the background. This is an old 10-second challenge to old Bernie Smurf. Bernie, do not swallow this in 10 seconds, Bernie, and I challenge you to swallow it as well. But Bernie, what I also would like to tell you is, man, to swallow my name out of your mouth. I'm in jail for the last couple of weeks. You have Martin Conroy there, the little pansy bastard, carrying messages back and forth. I'm out for the last 4 or 5 days. You all talk about me, Bernie. There's 200-300 of ye. There's only one of me, kid. There's only one of me. You'll get me involved in things that has nothing got to do with me. Only to the fact that I'm a gay mule around the road, this, that, and the other. I have no problem with you. Well, actually, right now I do, to be quite honest with you. Because you're bringing my name around the place. Barney Smurf, Barney Smurf, Barney Smurf. I couldn't give a fuck who you were. I will kill you in your sleep, you bastard, you. But listen, I say that politely. Keep my fucking name out of your mouth, yeah? The only thing I'm going to say to you, because you're in the middle of the house, Bernie, I kill you in your sleep, you bastard. My reputation speaks for itself. Now, in relation to Smurfs and townies, and this, that, and the other, I have no problem with any breed of a traveller inside in Galway. I have the best of time for ward swings, this, that, and the other, bloody, bloody fucking black. I have the best time in the world for any man that has time for me. But I'm going to put it out there, there's a fool of a handicapped bastard, I don't know where he got his balls out of, texting me, saying this, that, and the other, and it's Stephen Tony. Stephen, this is a message for you, Bernie, and pass your message. I'm just going to give you one more warning, Bernie. Even when I do go back to you, if I have to go back to you, and if I have to hear you say my name one more time, trust me, buddy, you won't wake up from your sleep. But Stephen, tell me, I swear on my son's grave, God forgive me, I'm not Declan Ward. I won't pull up in the car beside you and start roaring and shouting and hollering and polluting and this, that, and the other. Do you not remember the time, Stephen Tony, when you came out to Jason McDonough, Duke 24 for a bag of coke, and you were saying you were coming up with golf clubs to his house and this, that, and the other, and I'd tell you to cop onto yourself. I said, if you were stuck for 20 hours, I said that I'd look after you. Listen to me, you see all this crap here from around me? I'm not short of a few quid. I'm only out of jail for the last few days. I don't have nothing. As for man, I own Galway City. Galway City is my city. Not you, not a Smurf, not a Ward, not a Bear, not this, do nothing to fuck with me. And when I tell you why, and I don't say that as a threat, it's because I don't get on with the younger generation. It's all the older boys and it's the older generation, because they have good time for me and I have good time for them. Because you see this stays short. You have two of them, you want them for a reason. The last message I have is, Bernie Smurf, I swear my son's grave, I'm giving you one last chance to take my name out of your mouth. And Stephen, tell me, as I just said it, on my son's grave, when I catch you, Stephen, I'm not going to be a Declan Ward for you at all. You know me, Stephen. You know me. You know you started on the wrong person. You fucking shitty little, shiny little bastard. I don't mind having Declan my conscience. And trust me when I tell you, man, I look forward to having your Declan my conscience. Now listen to me, if you don't mind, I'm going to swallow this out behind no hair, no goodbyes in 10 seconds and this, that, and the other, la 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 la. But tell you the truth, just fuck off from around me, you fucking dirt. Fuck off.